Is your car's stereo overheating, leaving you worried it might get damaged? Excessive heat can cause your stereo to malfunction, but don't worry, we've got the solution. Watch this video and stay with SetNFix. To enhance performance and keep things running smoothly, a cooling fan is essential. This fan will push the internal heat out, preventing overheating. I'm using a 2-inch, 12-volt DC fan. You can find a suitable spot to install it, either inside or outside the car stereo. However, existing air holes are not suitable enough to the screw holes of the fan. I am drilling holes using the fan as a template. When installing the cooling fan, it's crucial to determine the correct airflow direction. Since our goal is to expel the internal heat, you'll need to check the arrow printed on the fan, which indicates the direction of airflow. Align the fan so that it effectively pushes the hot air out of the car stereo, ensuring optimal cooling. Additionally, it's important to be cautious during installation. You'll be using nuts and bolts to secure the fan in place, but you must ensure that no metal parts come into contact with the car stereo's main circuit board. This is vital to prevent any potential short circuits or damage to the system. Take your time to carefully position the fan and securely fasten it while keeping these safety precautions in mind. Now, it's time to find a power source for your cooling fan that provides 12 volts. It's important to note that we don't want the fan running continuously, so connecting it directly to the battery line isn't ideal. Doing so would keep the fan on even when the car is turned off, which isn't necessary and could drain your battery. The best solution is to connect the fan to the accessories line. This line is only active when the car is in use, meaning the fan will only operate when needed, when the car and stereo are on. This not only conserves energy but also ensures that your cooling system is working efficiently whenever the car stereo is in use. Take your time to locate the accessories line in your car's electrical system. Once you've identified it, carefully connect the fan, making sure the connection is secure and insulated to prevent any electrical issues. By doing this, you ensure that your fan functions optimally, protecting your car stereo from overheating whenever you're on the road. However, to properly install the cooling fan inside the car stereo casing, I first needed to remove the wires from the fan. This step allowed me to thread the wires through the casing without obstruction. Once the wires were inside, I carefully soldered the power supply back onto the fan, ensuring a strong and reliable connection. This is a critical step because a poor soldering job can lead to power issues or even damage the fan over time. With the fan now wired and ready, the next step was to connect its power cable to the appropriate power connector inside the stereo. It's important to choose the right connector to ensure the fan operates only when needed, in sync with the car's electrical system. After connecting the power cable, I took a moment to double-check all the connections, ensuring that everything was securely in place and functioning as expected. Once you're confident that all connections are solid, it's time to reassemble the car stereo. Start by carefully reconnecting the main board, making sure that all components are properly aligned and secured. This step is crucial, as any misalignment can lead to operational issues or damage. After the main board is in place, you can reattach the casing. Use screws to securely fasten the casing, ensuring that everything is tightly sealed and protected. By following these steps with care, you'll ensure that your cooling fan is properly installed and that your car stereo is well protected from overheating, ready to deliver optimal performance. With everything now installed, it's time to test the car stereo system. As you're probably aware, when powering the car stereo externally, it's important to connect both the power and accessories wires. Now, I'm ready to power up the car stereo. As you can see, the fan is working perfectly as soon as the power is supplied. This simple solution will effectively protect your car stereo from overheating, preventing issues like sluggish performance or sudden shutdowns. That wraps up today's video. What do you think about this solution? Do you have any alternative ideas or tips on this topic? Share your thoughts in the comments below. I'll see you in the next video. Stay innovative and stay with SetNFix.